This website is not secure. Since it's missing an SSL certificate, it's showcasing a public error to each and every user. In most cases, your web hosting provider takes care of the SSL certificates for you. But what if you're hosting on a VPS? Well, I have a DigitalOcean VPS running on Ubuntu, and my website is using NGINX. Here's how to solve the SSL problem the best way possible, with some extra security tips sprinkled in. So, log into your VPS provider dashboard to locate the IP address of your server. Then open up a preferred console. I'll just use CMD on Windows and log into your VPS. I'll log in as root by typing in SSH root at my IP address. The first thing you want to do is run sudo apt update and sudo apt upgrade to check if any of your system packages have newer versions available, and let it finish. Generally, it is a very good practice to use the latest, most secure versions of stuff, so make it into your habit. Next, you'll need to run sudo apt install certbot python 3 certbot nginx to install certbot for nginx. If you're using Apache, replace the nginx line with Apache, but nginx is just objectively better, so you should be using it for your websites, and making the switch from Apache to nginx is honestly not that hard. But this video is not about that. After it's installed and ready, we need to ask certbot to issue an SSL certificate for our desired domain names. So use this command and input your domain names. In my case, the domain is testingemit.net, so I'll use testingemit.net and www.testingemit.net. Then I'll need to type in my email address. So I'll go with emit@emit.reviews, and I'll agree to the terms of service, but won't agree to the receiving promotional emails part. So at this point, the SSL certificate is configured, but our server is not using all of the best security practices just yet. So let's edit our nginx config file to include proper security headers to protect against cyber attacks, implement WordPress-specific optimizations, implement static file caching, and block access to sensitive information, as well as force HTTPS usage over HTTP. So the version without an SSL certificate is simply unreachable. To do this, you'll need to type in this command and paste in these settings. I'll have them all together with the rest of the commands in the pinned comment down below. Make sure to replace testingemit.net to your website name, like whatever your domain name is, everywhere in this file. To save, click on Ctrl S, and to close this, click Ctrl X. Now, we'll need to enable our configuration, so our WordPress website uses this nginx config file instead of any other ones. First of all, let's create a symbolic link by typing in this command. This links our WordPress website together with this new nginx configuration. I also like to remove the default configuration file so I don't get confused later down the line if I need to make additional changes. You can do that by typing in this command. Obviously, keep in mind that you don't have to create a whole new nginx config file with the name WordPress. You can name it whatever you want, and you can even use the default file that already exists. It's just something I've done for this tutorial on a brand new site that didn't have any prior configuration, so it's easier that way for me. With that out of the way, let's update our WordPress configuration. Type in this command to get started. Then use the arrow keys to scroll down until you see, that's all, stop editing. And right before that line, just paste in the code like this from the pinned comment down below. Again, I'll have everything down there. So at this point, all of our configuration is pretty much done for this website and this specific case. So all we need to do is restart nginx by running this command. And if you visit your website, the SSL certificate should start working upon refreshing the page. Additionally, you can run a security header check to see the score. Yes, it's not perfect, but I don't like messing with the APIs since it could break your projects by a large margin and then you would need to configure everything differently. But an A is already way better than what most websites have, which is nothing. So I hope your SSL certificate is working by this point and you've learned some extra security practices that you can apply to your projects. My name is Emmet. Good luck creating your websites, and I'll see you around.